Hello guys, welcome back to our channel, The Collector's Hub. Let's continue our survival drive in this strange place. If you like this kind of game and would like us to continue with it, give this video a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.
Es un hermoso día para salir a caminar, a contarte experiencias con todo tipo de luz y amor. Unifiquemos nuestra conciencia con el mar y compartamos lo que permita para adaptarnos también nosotros al de ellos.
Hello, my dear residents of the Arrow. This is your $1 billion I'm very pleased to let you know that Sierra's been chosen as the site for the very first annual Ring Fair. That's right, next month, our town square is the epicenter for the greatest spectacle of technology on Earth. So many of you really can pay for a little town behind us. Wouldn't be crowded. Now with the all new is that every household, we have invited every single one of our 3,000 families just to take home their very own piece of living tank. Now ain't that grand? So it's time to put those thinking caps on and decide what kind of life to buy. ladies, deputies, responders are campaigning your husband to the fourth hour of the world in the air of new and new that. But I will. To the monthly tongue. Is that not what the pathology is for? An animal one.
Thank you. Thank you. You better not be tracking all that zone goo into my garage.
Gurlis.
My apologies, Gurlis. Didn't you discuss the new book, Minty Fresh Nightmares, and how going to bed with fresh breath is the root cause to all mouth-based nightmares?
Yes. This is cool. Nothing you'll eat before bed.
So why would fresh breath give me nightmares about my teeth?
Thank you. to anyone who can hear this, please keep an eye out for the mastermind. Here, in the village town, trusty build with the
10 fingers and toes accounted for? But don't just count them. You gotta check and make sure you didn't bring back any toe hands.
Anyone who can hear this, please keep an eye out for my cat here. The orange tabby has to build
with a snaggle.
Really worried about him.
He's been
cared like this before, never this long, and like, hang on. It's here. Oh, all right, never mind, everyone. Peter came home. You gotta stop scaring me like that, buddy. Come on, let's get you dry.
Thank you. was a disaster.
Not only am I not able to decode them,
but I'm trapped in hold. My lab, call it that, is now destroyed and I barely got the thing outside. Unless I knew,
thank you.
bring back anything good this time?
The Lynn Fair. Arda advertised it as a good old-fashioned small-town get-together, a miniature world fair of sorts for the hard-working government employees and their families that lived in Sierra Town. The flyers and brochures I've gotten my hands on promised all manner of things, mundane and fantastical. Kiss your low-tech washing machine goodbye, take home this limb nebulizer, and zap your clothes and diapers clean. Why break your back trimming your lawn when LimTech can transform your grass into something more? This push to get LimTech into the homes of zone residents, housewives in particular, was a deliberate and strategic move. The cynical reason, and most popular interpretation, is that it was a PR push to rehabilitate LimTech's image. By 1973, there'd been enough reports of radioactive fallout and inexplicable disappearances that suspicion of what Arda was doing was high. Where were you when the CRM incident happened?
At base camp, about 20 miles out of town. Sirens went off during dinner, and we barely had time to wonder whether it was a drill or real before the shockwave rolled through. Luckily, we'd been through the disaster procedure days before. We dove under our tables to take cover. I mean, we were just kids, and at first thrilled for the drama unfolding in real time. It was hours before Arda came to extract us. By that time, we'd scrambled up onto a hill to signal for help and saw
Take your time.
It's been 20 years, and I still can't go anywhere near a county fair of any sort.
What did they tell you had happened?
Nothing. They were all business, hurrying us onto the trucks with boarded up windows. We weren't even allowed back in our cabins to pack our belongings. They breezed us out of the zone. It wasn't until days later, when most of us were deposited in an orphanage, that we learned that our parents died.
Lou's account is one of the most damning and holds up to the best of my verification efforts. She's told that story many times and hadn't changed this story in the ensuing years. Chalk it up to good memory or deeply seated trauma, but it is, as far as I can tell, real. The stories from others, however, inspire a healthy dose of skepticism. Those who weren't too scared of government retaliation were few. And the ones who shared their stories loved their 15 minutes of fame a little too much. Any talk show or gossip rag or cheap date willing to listen heard from these types and made piecing together the zone's true history for someone like me, decades later, a migraine-inducing experience. Because these stories, as every good gossip knows, morphed over time. What started as the most powerful lightning storms recorded on Earth turned into UFOs touching down. An innocent spiderweb became something to be avoided on pain of death. A grassy lawn, left untended, became a feeding ground for something called burp bunnies. The tales became taller as the years went by, and the more I heard, the more my suspension of disbelief left me. And while the CRM disaster was only one of the many incidents that occurred over the zone's 32-year history, it is the one I return to as a prime example. Whatever happened there in CRM is the type of disaster that caused the creation of the exclusion zone in the first place. We can extrapolate from what little we know of what happened here. If this is the one story to get out, how many more horrors did LIM technology cause?